A popular photo book manufacturer prices books based on the number of photos you want to put in it. For two recent orders, they charged $20 for a book with 5 photos and $30 for a book with 25 photos. Explain your answer in the context of this problem for C and D. So first of all, we're asked to find to write 2 ordered pairs. So they tell us to put the photos first. So we're going to start with 5 photos. So if you order 5 photos, the price is $20. Okay, so now we're going to write another ordered pair. So the number of photos, if it's 25, the cost is $30. Okay, part B says, using those 2 ordered pairs, find the equation of a line that can model this situation. So I'm going to go ahead and write a line, and my equation of the line, I'm going to use y equals mx plus b. So since I'm using slope-intercept form, I need to go ahead and first find the slope. So the first step, so I have my 2 points. Okay, so we're going to use our formula for slope. So I need to go ahead and first subtract the y values, or our output variable. So I'm going to go ahead and subtract. And remember that either formula here will work. So I'm going to go ahead and use this one. So I'm going to subtract my y, so 20 minus 30. And then I'm going to subtract the x's. So I'm going to do 5 minus 25. And then I'm going to simplify. Negative divided by negative is a positive. And we get 1/2. So now we know this. Y equals 1/2 x. Now we need to go ahead and find b. That's the next part. Okay, so now we need to figure out what number to put into our equation for our y-intercept, our b value. So since we were given 2 points, we already used them to find the slope. Now we're going to use one of them. It doesn't matter which one, but in an ordered pair, we have an x and a y. So when we're solving equations, we can only have one unknown. So I'm going to go ahead and substitute for y, the 20. And for x, 5, so that we can solve for b. So half of 5 is 2.5. You could also leave it as 5/2 if you'd like. And now to get b by itself, you need to subtract 2.5 from both sides. Okay, so now we have our b value. This is also correct if we put a 0 there. So that was part B. It said, using your 2 ordered pairs, write an equation to model this situation. So the rate of change is the variable in this equation here in front of our x. That is our slope, that is our rate of change. So you could divide 1 by 2 and write it as a decimal, as 0.5. You don't have to have both of these answers, but you need to have one of them. So if you decide to write your answer as 1/2, then you need to explain what the 1 and the 2 represent. So I'll go over it both ways. So remember, to find slope, we could think of it as rise over run. And when I hear rise, it sounds like wise. Rise, wise. So that's how I remember that I'm going to find the change in the output, the y in my equation here. So I'm going to take the 1/2 if I'm trying to explain what the 1 and the 2 represent. And the 1 represents your output variable, which is price. So the one represents price, and the two represents photos. So we would say it costs a dollar for every two photos. So I would explain that the rate of change is 1/2, and this means it costs an additional dollar every two photos. Now, if you decide instead of writing 1/2, you decide to write it as a decimal, you need to explain what the 0.5 represents. So we know that rate of change is the output, change in the output over the change in the input. Well, then you know that you could put a 1 in any denominator, okay? So here we have the output, which is the Y, so price, and the photos. So we explain that as it costs, not 0.5, it costs 50 cents for every one photo. So 0.5 of a dollar, that's 50 cents. It costs 50 cents for a dollar, or for one photo. So it costs an additional 50 cents per photo. Okay, so now we're asked to find the vertical intercept. So if we think of a graph, this is the vertical intercept right here, and that's exactly what this number here tells us, where it's going to cross that vertical axis. So in other words, it would cross, let's just say, like right there. Well, that 17.5 there, that ordered pair right there is you don't go left, you don't go right, you just go straight up. So the X is 0 and the Y is 17.5. That's how we write that as an ordered pair. So the vertical intercept is 0, 17.5. And now we have to explain what that means. So the 0 represents the number of photos, and the 17.5 represents a cost. So we would, instead of saying 17.5, we would say $17.50. So we have to explain what this means. So this is saying if you don't buy any photos, the price is still $17.50. So you could say if no photos are purchased, there is an initial cost of $17.50. And then we could explain further, what could that be? Why would, if you're buying this photo album, is it still costing you $17.50 if you don't buy any photos? So you could explain that maybe this is a shipping cost, or maybe they're charging you the $17.50 for the book, and then you're paying 50 cents per photo. So that's how we would explain what the vertical intercept represents. So I would say this means if no photos are purchased, the cost is $17.50. This could be the cost for the photo album without the photos.